in terms of whether wins and losses question. I think the issue of even the slightest degree of mutual trust or accommodation that the India-China relationship had achieved after bilateral treaties and agreements since sort of the Rajiv Gandhi consensus, as it's known, in 1988 or later on in 1993. By breaking all of that, the rules of engagement have changed. And, you know, and the keep what really worked in keeping the peace, if you will, for 45 years has all gone to dust. And this is clearly a political choice made by China, which has naturally come at a cost for both sides. Now, what I think the Chinese actions have done actually has triggered a rethinking, like I said, on, you know, what is the way India calibrates its China policy. And again, achieve what was perhaps even more difficult in the past, which is that bring the India and US together, especially in terms of managing the rise of China and closer coordination of, you know, how to manage Chinese assertive action. Today, India, whose economic relationship with China has been very over-dependent, while there is an understanding and an assessment that complete decoupling is not possible, I think what you see is a series of steps being taken, you know, whether it's the resilient supply chain initiative, where, you know, you're looking at rewiring of global supply chains, which are either completely not dependent or partially dependent on China. You have a lot of these conversations on maintaining access to global commons, including the question of South China Sea, which India was not very vocal about earlier, to keeping in check techno-nationalism. You know, you have clearly formats like the quadrilateral dialogue, which are now working at finding durable solutions in the technology domain, which are not dependent on China again. And of course, India's, you know, attempts at becoming the hub for vaccine manufacturing and distribution, the post-pandemic sort of global order, with the help of other like-minded countries. Now, this push for the coalition of the willing, if you will, against perceived Chinese bullying would not have happened at the scale and the speed that it has in the absence of Galwan. And I think that's something that would come as a cost to both China, and it's something that's a cost that India is willing to pay in terms of, you know, being, even if China accuses it of, you know, coming together with the quadrilateral dialogue countries as the Asian NATO or otherwise, that India is no longer hesitant to take certain actions, however misperceived as they are by China. So I think that's really what has sort of changed after the Galwan Valley clash.
If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about the Eastern Ladakh crisis, please check out the other videos in our exclusive interview series here on our YouTube channel, and visit stratlearning.org to enroll for free in Deterrence in Southern Asia.